Welcome. So are you excited for a fun learning session? And as you read the title already, the topic of today's session is increased WordPress speed. I know a lot of you are facing this problem when WordPress is not so fast. In today's tutorial, we will see how we can increase WordPress speed. And in just 5 minutes, we're going to address a lot of issues like compression, caching, minified JS and CSS files, combines files, image CDN, and much more. If you don't know what all these things are, you just follow the tutorial and we will understand what these things are. And if you don't want to understand, you just follow the tutorial and make your WordPress website faster. So let's go into the tutorial and see in just 5 minutes, with help of a plugin WP Fastest Cache, how you can make your WordPress website very fast. So as I told in my previous videos, there is a very good tool which is called gtmetrics.com. You log on onto this website and paste your website URL and click test your site. It will analyze your website, and once it is ready, it will give you a lot of suggestions that how we can increase your website speed. So this is my website speed result with gtmetrics.com, and you can see here my website is loading in 6.5 seconds. And you can see there are a lot of issues which gtmetrics identified in terms of speed. You can see here gtmetrics is suggesting me to enable compression, leverage browser caching, inline small CSS, serve resource from a consistent URL, inline small JavaScript, defer passing of JavaScript. There are a lot of issues, and I'm sure not everybody of you is interested. What are those? You just want to fix them because you're running your own business. So today we are going to solve all these issues in just 5 minutes. Okay. So once you are inside your WordPress dashboard, we are going to install a plugin which is WP Fastest Cache. To install this new plugin, from left sidebar, hover on plugins and then click on add new. And now we will search for WP Fastest Cache plugin. And this is our awesome plugin which we are going to install and solving all the speed issues. I want to mention here, this is a very fast tutorial for the fast setup. We are not going to cover very advanced website, but if you have a simple website, with the help of this plugin, you can significantly increase your website speed. So now we click on install now. Once it is installed, click activate. Okay, now our plugin is activated. Now from left sidebar, in the end, you can see this menu, WP Fastest Cache. Click on WP Fastest Cache. As you remember, we have a lot of issues here. So we are going to fix all this issue with help of WP Fastest Cache plugin. So first thing is cache system. With cache system, this plugin creates static HTML files of your website. So when somebody visits your website pages are served very fast. And then we are going to use preload. This create, as you can see, this create cache of all site automatically. You can choose to make homepage, post and pages. I prefer just these three options. You can choose other options also. Then we have logged in users. If you enable this option, every time you're logged in, you don't see cache version, because sometimes you're working on your website, so you don't want to see cached version of your website. So I will enable this option also. And then don't show the cached version for desktop to mobile devices. And then we have some options to clear cache. So sometime when you publish a new post, you want to clear all the cache. Then when you update the post, you also want to clear the cache of page or post. So we are going to choose this option also. Then we are going to minify HTML. It decreases the size of HTML on your website. Then we're going to minimize CSS files. CSS files are the design files. So we are going to minify those so that the website becomes less heavy, the files become less in weight. Then we're going to combine CSS file. So we have a lot of CSS file on website. We are going to combine all those files in one file. So when somebody visits your website, they will download just one CSS file. Then we're going to combine JS files. Then we are going to choose gzip. With gzip, all the data transfer between your browser and the server happens with a zip format file, and it is very small in size. Then we are going to use browser caching. If you want to know more about browser caching, I made a video about it. I'll put a link on top right where I discuss in detail what is browser caching. It's a very nice feature to have on your website. Then we are going to disable emojis, because WordPress has a lot of emojis which we really don't use all the time, so you can disable those also. And once we are done with all these things, we are going to click submit. Second thing we are going to use is CDN. So here we have four options of CDN. If you are a beginner, I want to use the CDN by Photon. It's very simple to implement. You can just click on CDN by Photon. What it does, all the images on the website, they are served from WordPress CDN URL. So you can choose this one from here and then next. And then you can choose your GIF, JPEG and PNG images. They all are served from the CDN. CDN is just a fast server from where your images are loaded on the website. Then click next, and then next, next, and then finish. So this is all what you need to improve your website speed with this plugin. So this is the fastest way to increase your website speed. I want to mention here, if you see something broken in your website, you can come back here. You can one by one, you can uncheck one option. For example, I can uncheck minify CSS and I save submit, and then I try to load my website. If it loads good, I can keep this uncheck, and it doesn't change, I can make sure that this feature was not making a problem. So I can check it again and try to uncheck another option. And then I test my website that which option is making site bad. Normally these options are very safe. They do not make any issues in 99.9% of cases. But in case you face some problem, you can just try and uncheck the option which is troubling on your website. So in the end, I click submit. Now we'll go back to the gtmetrics.com. Okay, now I try to retest my website. I'll just click on retest and I'll open this a new tab so I can compare that what changed on my website after installing WP fastest cache and using those options. So this is the retest result. You can see here my website is loading in 6.5 seconds. Now you can see my website is loading in just 1.4 seconds. So this is a big change from 6.5 seconds. In few minutes, I make my website load in 1.4 seconds. You can see it fixed a lot of issues. For example, enable compression, leverage browser caching. You can see enable compression is fixed. You can see leverage browser caching, inline small CSS. All these issues are fixed or they are very much better than before. So this is a nice way to increase your website speed. I hope you like the tutorial. I'll highly recommend you to subscribe to my channel in order to stay updated in your website game. Like this video, share it with your friends and family who want to make the WordPress website faster. Thank you so much. See you in another video.